say goodbye to your cumbersome skills matrix, because managing and tracking certificates has never been easier with Salus. Upload or create your worker certificates on their behalf, or let them do it themselves. Create custom certificate types and providers to standardize and track all your certificates across the organization. In this video, I'm going to show you how to set up and manage your certificates with Salus step by step. Setting up your certificates involves these three steps. First, before you get your certificates onto the platform, you'll need to set up your certificate types and providers so you can standardize your data, which will give you access to accurate reporting. Next, you'll upload the certificates so they're entered onto the platform in a consistent way. And lastly, you'll set up your reports, which involves creating notifications and shared links for your stakeholders to report on certificate compliance. To get started, set up your certificate types and providers. Go to the main menu and click Certificates. Navigate to the Types tab. A certificate type is how you'll categorize your certificates. For example, WHIMIS, Fall Protection, and First Aid are all examples of certificate types. Click on Add Type. In the dialog box, give the certificate type a name. Switching the required toggle on captures this data point, which flags the certificate is required. Clicking Save adds the certificate type to the list. Repeat the process until all your certificate types are set up. Certificate providers are optional, but are created in the same way. To do this, navigate to the Providers tab and click Add Provider. Input the provider names of your certificates, for example, Red Cross, or whatever the names are of the training organizations your workers get their certificates from. With the types and providers created, you're now ready to start getting your worker certificates into the system. The first way is for the company admin to upload and enter a certificate's details on behalf of a worker. This method gives you full control of how the data is entered. The second method is for your worker to upload their own certificates via Salus Mobile. In this instance, additional administration is required by the company admin to ensure certificate data is standardized for all workers. This is done by manually assigning a certificate type and a provider to the worker certificate entry, which ensures consistency in the data for reporting purposes. Let's see each of these methods in action. In the certificates area, navigate to the worker tab and click Add Certificate. The Create option provides fields to fill in details and generate a record for internal training. For example, new hire orientation. Upload provides the fields to capture information for external certification and uploads the certificate from the provider. In this case, we'll select Upload. Select the worker you're uploading the certificate against, the certificate type, the provider, and the expiry date of the certificate. Click Upload to find the image or document of the certificate. You can upload the front and back of the certificate using these buttons. Click Save, which saves the certificate against the worker's profile and shows it in the Workers tab and also in the Company tab. Using the second method, workers can upload their own certificates via Salus Mobile. Clicking Add shows fields to upload the front and back view of their certificate and enter the type and expiry date of the certificate. A download for offline toggle is also available, which gives workers access to their certifications when they don't have an internet connection on a work site. Once a certificate is saved and uploaded by a worker, as a company admin, you'll need to approve the certificate entry and standardize the certificate type and provider so entries across all workers are consistent for reporting purposes. The certificates submitted by workers appear in the Workers tab. Here, you can see which ones are not yet approved. Sort the certificates to find the unapproved certificates which have been uploaded by workers but not yet checked and approved. To approve a certificate upload, click into the certificate, then click Edit. Standardize the data by selecting a certificate type and provider. If the certificate references a type or provider that's not on the drop-down list, you'll need to add them in the Types tab or the Provider tab. Once you've standardized the data, click Save. Check you're happy with the uploaded certificate images. Click Approve. Going back, we can see the certificate entry is now approved, and when we navigate to the Company tab, The standardized entry now appears on this list, which is what your reports will reference. You can set up and run reports on certificates in the company tab, which is where your standardized certificate entries are shown. This means you can run reports on the required certificates that haven't been uploaded, as well as those that have. Use the filters provided at the top to see this in action. For example, in this search for the worker Saul Green, you can see the certifications that are on the system, the ones that are missing, and those that have expired. Other reports you may want to run are to find workers who have certifications on the platform but have passed the expiry date. Using the status filter and selecting expired would produce this result. Or you might want to see who is not certified for a certificate, for example, first aid, so you can follow up with them. Another useful feature of certificates is the ability to create shared links. To create a shared link for certificates, navigate to the Shared Links tab and click New Shared Link. These links provide real-time access to stakeholders who do not have access to the Salus platform. Through the link, they can see customized information about certificates belonging to a site or group of workers, which updates automatically. Create a name for the link and select a type from the drop-down list. That is, if you're running a report for certifications against the site or against workers. For example, if you select Site, you can choose the site you want to report on, and then under Certificate Type, you can select the certificates of interest or leave the list blank to report on all of the certificates. Conversely, if you choose to report against a worker, you can select this in the Type dropdown. Then add your workers by selecting the checkboxes next to their names and selecting their certificates of interest or leaving it blank to report on all of the certificates. Clicking Create adds your live link onto the list, which you can send to your stakeholders. Finally, with certificates. If you or anyone else in your company needs to be notified of impending certificate expiration, add emails to this list for notifications to be sent as a reminder. Go to the Notifications tab and click Add Certificate Email. Adding emails to this list generates automatic notifications that are sent to the emails identified when certificates are within 30 days of expiry. The certificate dashboard also allows you to view a snapshot of your certificate data, providing you with a sense of how you're tracking. Using the certificate features on the Salus platform allows you to easily obtain certificate information from your workers to then standardize your data to generate meaningful and useful reports to fulfill your compliance requirements. With the use of reports, notifications, and shared links, you can easily keep your stakeholders informed in real time and streamline your work processes with all the certificate data you'll ever need at your fingertips.